I'm not saying it's going to be easy, but I'm saying first step is try to understand how the system works. Second step is register the work and try to sell your works. And you don't need to sell the work, just give them a license.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief.
Do I have to register with your office to be copyright protected? Simple answer, no. Let me explain to you why sometimes registration is necessary, but you don't have to register. So, in this video, we're going to talk about this. When is it important to register your copyright and when not? And also look at this requirements of copyright and see what we can do. So let's go to the drawing board. You see here, this is how you're going to do in order to discuss everything. But let's look at it, the definition of copyright. You see here, het auteursrecht is het uitsluitend recht van den maker van een werk van letterkunde, wetenschap, kunst, bla 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 bla. This is Dutch. Yeah? But if you look at here, this is the English translation. Nothing wrong with that. But copyright is exclusive right of the author of literary, science, artistic work or his assignees to make such work public and to reproduce it subject to limitation provided in the law. Okay, this is not a bad translation. I'm not saying it's really good, but if you look at this, do you see somewhere in here that you need to register? No. So do I have to register? No. They are saying you will get automatically on copyright. You do not need to register. Nothing in the law is saying that you need to register. Done. Case closed. Right? No, not really. You're asking yourself now, okay, there are some people that registered their work. Why did they do that? And when is this necessary? That's a good question. If you didn't ask yourself that, don't worry about that. I will answer this question so you can get a little bit inside why people are doing that. When you understand how the system works, it's going to help you in the long run. So, we agree, registration, not necessary. You do not need to register. So, why do people register? Answer, proof. The thing is, when you create something, it's hard to prove that you were the first one. Sometimes it's hard to prove that you create something on that date. And if you have a picture, for example, if you create a picture, inside the picture in the data, you will have some data that I can show you that you created on that date. There's nothing wrong with that. But imagine you paint something. You create a painting. And the question is, when did you create the painting or when did you finish it? And when did you have a copyright on it? That's something you need to ask yourself. The thing is, what people most of the time do is they register the copyright because when there is a problem with the copyright, they can always prove, hey, you see, on this date, I registered my copyright. So this date, from this date, I'm the first one. So if you come after the date, so this is a date, if you come after, you're gonna lose. But if you can prove that you create something before the date, so the thing that there's a discussion about, if you can prove that you create something before the date, then the chance that you're going to win is really high. But there can be other factors that can prevent you from winning a case or get you to your point. But in this case, we're just going to look at the date. The date is important. And when you have proof that you have certain kind of date, it's going to give you a head sprung in certain kind of cases and in certain kind of situation. For example, if someone claimed that they created a website on, let's say, 2017, and let's say in January, if they cannot prove it, then they have a problem. What they can do is they can go to the website Internet Archive, and in Internet Archive, most of the time you can get a copy of your website because they keep a database of all the websites around the globe. So you can get a copy of your website. If you cannot find it in there, it's hard to prove. That's an example. And what most people do is sometimes they go to the IP office and they register the copyright, because in certain kind of cases you may not get, let's say, a patent or trademark, but you can always prove that you have a copyright or certain kind of things. Let's say, for example, you create a software and there's a high chance you can get a patent for that. There's a high chance, doesn't mean you will get it, but you know it's going to be risky. So what do? You register the whole process as copyright in IP office. Also, you apply for the patent. If you do not get it, then you still have the copyright. But most of the time when you're applying for a patent, an IP lawyer will help you with this kind of cases. But this is one example. Another example is, for example, that let's say you create a machine. You have the whole process, and this is kind of dirty, by the way, but let me tell you how it works. You create a whole machine, a whole process, and the thing is, you apply for a patent, but it got rejected, and someone else already had a patent on it. But yeah, no, the thing is, this is not going to be fun to talk about it, because then you need to explain more how patent works. But technically, it comes based to this. Imagine you publish all the finding in here online, and nobody has that link. It's like a hyperlink, but it's really special, so it's hard to get it on in the search engine. You will tell the other person, if you don't want me to publish this, yeah, no. Thing is, let's remove this, because I think this example we're going to be too hard for people. I'm going to delete this in this video, but let's start with the all part. So why people register, let me remove this so I can do it again. So why do people register copyright? It's just for the proof. If you have a situation where you need to prove that you have got copyright on certain kind of things, if you register something, you get a paper that you register on that date. And when you have that date, the people that come after cannot do anything. But if people come before and they say, hey, we are before that date, you have a problem. So the date is really important, and the proof is also really important. And in order to help you, you have certain kind of IP office that can help you register your work in order to prevent these kind of things. So, nice example is, if you create something and you want proof that you have copyright on it, on the process how you create it, you can write down the whole process in a Word document, how everything works, and you can register this. As soon as someone copy this, or as soon as someone copy this and use it without your permission, you can go after them. But then you need to look at the situation. Are they really using your copyright? Are they really using certain kind of things from you? That's difficult. But if you look at something really simple, so that's a process. Let's look at a songwriter. You wrote a song. Let's say you wrote a song. Really nice song, nice combination. And you register. As soon as you register and everything went well and you meet the requirement of copyright, you have a copyright on a song. If someone copied this song or part of it and used it without your permission, you can sue them. Same with the song. All those things you can register. Same with the book. You can register those things. If you create a play, if you create a lecture, you can register those things. If someone copy it and use it without your permission, you can sue those people. So when we look at this, yes, proof can be handy, but most of the time people do not use this. Let me give you an example. I know some certain kind of artists, they create nice things. They put it online, they earn a little bit money from that, and that's it. But they do not register their work, because when you look at certain kind of situations, sometimes people have different kind of business model. Some business model require you to register the copyright, some of them don't. What I mean by that is, when you register your copyright, you can give other people license. because you can prove, hey, I have proof here, I have copyright on it, you want to go use my thing for your commercial purposes, here, you're allowed to use it, but you need to pay me for it. That's a business model. So you have your company here, you're an artist, you create music. So let's say you create music, you register this music, and a person come to you, okay, you know what, I want to use your music in my video. You give those people license to use it. And people think this can be complicated, but doesn't have to. You do not need an agent to do this for you. You can do it yourself. You can create templates for license and register your music. Just go to the IP office in your region. In this case, in Holland, you can go to the in the BBIPO, Benelux Intellectual Property. You can go there, register your music, show them the license that you can use it, and then you can get a fee every month of every year for using your music. You do not need other people to do that. I know as an artist you think, I don't have time for that, but think about it. If you get your shit together, sorry for that word, if you get your shit together, you can build a lot of things. I see, for example, there are some artists, I'm really proud to hear that. They are not big artists, but what they do was, okay, you know what? I'm gonna borrow you my painting. You can put it in your office. And if someone asks you to who made a painting, just promote me. Or if you have a restaurant, you can say, hey, you can borrow my paintings. I can put it in there. Okay? And if people want to buy it, they can buy it for me. But the restaurant can also pay you monthly a fee for using the painting. You don't have to sell them. You can just rent it. So you can rent music. You can rent art. You can do a lot of things. But the thing is, a lot of people do not know how to use that. So in order to answer the question we're talking about, these things, you can register them. So you have proof that you have copyright on it. And you can use that proof for in a contract. So in a contract, you will be like, the copyright is this beneath in the proof as an attachment of the contract. So let's say this is your contract. You put as an attachment the proof and the copyright what it is. And when you use that, it's easy for you to sell your thing. And what you need to keep in mind is try to keep that in mind. As an artist, you are creating stuff. And when you create stuff, you need to let the stuff work for you. And that's a big difference. When you have people, they work 9 to 5. Okay, they work and need to earn money. But if you create something, you let that thing work for you and you earn money. So you can look, okay, I create some painting. You know what? I'm not going to let the painting in my house. I'm going to go to the close by restaurant. Hey, you know what? I've got the kind of painting. Do you want to hang it up in your restaurant and refer people to me? After a while, you'll be like, okay, you know what? You really like the painting? You know what? Just pay me a monthly fee for that. Boom. You let the thing work for you. You don't have to do anything. And that's something that people don't understand. If you start taking action by yourself, it's going to help you a lot. And if you look at the question from this video, why? You can use the proof in order to make your case or the license more credible. So you'd be like, okay, this is the license. This is the proof that I have copyright on it. You can sign it and then you can use it. That's simple. And that creates credibility with people because they'll be like, okay, the person has this shit together. You understand what I mean? I understand that you as an artist, you're not going to go deep in the copyright. But if you do, it's going to help you in the long run. Even if you're a bad artist, you can get great. Because I saw certain kind of DJs, at the beginning, they were not good. But they took certain kind of steps that helped them grow a lot. And because of that, they became famous. And because of that, they also became good. But they had an entrepreneurial mindset. So just think about those things. Don't work for your money. Let the work for you. So create things and try to earn money from it. I'm not saying it's going to be easy. But I'm saying, first step is try to understand how the system works. Second step is register the work and try to sell your works. And you don't need to sell the work, just give them a license. When you give them a license, people will be like, okay, you know what? You know what? Put it there for three months or 1 month, see how they like it, and then be like, you know what? You like it? hey, let's just pay me, let's say $50 per month or $50 per 3 months, and then you have create something and people pay you monthly for that. And if you're wondering how can you do that with payment process and invoice, it's easy. What you need to do is go to PayPal. I'm not promoting PayPal or anything, just go to PayPal, create a system for yourself and send an invoice with PayPal and a pay link. That's simple. Everybody has a PayPal, or you have other agents or other, you have agents that can help you, but you have also other systems that can help you. For example, Stripe. When you create an account on this website, you can send them invoice and they can pay through the link, and that's it. So sometimes when you can send in a PayPal link, they can pay you monthly and you don't have to go after them. So technically you have someone subscribe every time which for your product, but you don't have to go after them. It's that simple. So why, if you look at the question, do I have to register with your office to protect it? No, you don't. But when you register something, it's the credibility is high. And when the credibility is high, it's easy for you to give people certain kind of license. It's easy for you to talk with other people. And it's also easy for you to promote your work. And last but not least, it can help you with proof to protect your work when necessary. So for example, if someone claimed that you were, they were first and they were before you, you can always show them the proof that you were before them. So if you have question about this, feel free to contact me on Discord. If you're new to this channel and you like this kind of thing, don't forget to subscribe. And was this information useful, don't forget to buy me coffee, and I will see you in the next video. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be